Well, hello, friends. Good Tuesday to you, and welcome to another daily devotional. I'm excited to be here with you today, and I'd like for us to continue our discussion of the fruit of the Spirit that we started a couple of times ago. It's from Galatians chapter 5, verses 22 and 23, and there it says that the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And what the Bible's saying is that as God's Spirit lives in us through His Son Jesus Christ and through the Word of God, that there will be fruit that is born in us, that there will be qualities of our lives that come as evidence that Holy Spirit is living inside of us. Now, we've already talked the last couple times about love, and we talked about joy. And today, we just want to give some thought to the concept of peace as part of what God wants to bear in our lives as His Spirit lives in us in any and every situation. I'd like to take you down on my property to a place where really very few people have ever been, actually. It's a wonderful place of peace, and it's kind of hard to get to. So let's go ahead and let's finish our walk on this deer path. You can see that right there. That's a buck rub there. That's where a buck, white-tailed deer buck, has just rubbed his antlers on there. And you can see that getting to this place is met with challenges. I've got to crawl under this log. So let me just set you up here for a minute on the log and try not to fall off. They say it's pretty easy to fall off a log. It's like falling off a log. So anyway, I'll groan my way underneath this thing. Get back up and come for you. Grab my Bible here. And we'll continue our walk through here. And, you know, as I said, not a lot of people have been to this little space on our property just because it's kind of hard to get to. And I haven't been here in some time, and so you can see it's a little bit overgrown now. I got to do this so I don't drop you and drop my Bible and everything else all at the same time. Okay, you're still there. Good. Good. Hang on. Hang on. It's a little bit tricky, but we'll get there. Shimmy down this little bank here. You can see that I some time ago built a little bench here so that I can sit here and enjoy this very peaceful spot with the Lord. Let me put you on the bench. Okay, there we go. Let's see if I can have a seat here without falling into the water. Maybe move some of the brush out of the way. Anyway, okay, so here we are. We made it. This is such a place of peace. You know, I think we all have those places in our lives that we can go and we can experience peace. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, and peace. And, you know, so just a continual reminder that these qualities of our lives are not something that we can really produce so much as they are what naturally comes when we live in the power of the Holy Spirit, with Holy Spirit living inside of us. Jesus is all about giving us peace. When He risen Jesus came to His disciples, He breathed on them and He said, "Receive my peace." Isaiah 26:3 says, "Thou will keep," I love the King James on this, "Thou will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on Thee, because he trusteth in Thee, O Lord." He trusteth in Thee. So Isaiah is saying when we fix our eyes on Jesus, then God will keep us in peace. And so, you know, anytime I'm not experiencing peace, when I'm feeling like I'm experiencing turmoil, chaos, uncertainty, anxiety, then I just gotta look for the Lord. I gotta figure out what has happened that has caused me to to maybe look away from the Lord. And you know, I only have to look away a couple of degrees and my peace is gone. But I know how to get it back. I fix my eyes on the Lord. Now, that's not always the easiest thing to do in your Bibles. In Hebrews, in the New Testament, Hebrews chapter 4. Hebrews chapter 4, it says, beginning in verse 1, it says, "Therefore, since the promise of entering his rest still stands, let us be careful that none of you be found to have fallen short of it." So there's a promise from God to enter into his rest. And we do that, he says, by faith in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. Verse 2 says, "For we also have had the gospel preached to us just as they did, but the message they heard was of no value to them because those who heard it did not combine it with faith." And so it's, you know, he's just talking about the possibility that a person can hear the gospel and not believe and not release their faith, not release their trust into the gospel and what Jesus did for us on the cross. But when we do that, we enter a rest. We enter into a place where we're not striving, we're not fighting, we're not arguing, we're not in chaos, we're not in anxiety, but we're in a place of rest and peace. "Thou will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee because he trusts in thee." Now remember, that's Old Testament in Isaiah, but it was looking forward to trusting in Christ, which is what really faith really, really is. But if you also look up at verse 11, you could read through that, but it says, "Let us therefore make every effort to enter that rest." That's such a puzzling, in some ways, such a puzzling and still so powerfully interesting phrase. Let's make every effort to enter into the rest. So you have to work hard to get to the resting place. And it's not that that we have to earn it, but it's that there are so many, many distractions to our keeping our eyes on Jesus, and maybe more so now than ever in our lives, keeping our eyes on Jesus. We're not enjoying, in many respects, our normal rhythms of fellowship and worship and the kinds of things that we really count on to be able to keep our eyes on Jesus. And so the word that I really want to give you today is, hey, work hard to get to the place of peace. Just like we just worked, we worked and struggled to get back to this place. But, you know, it says work hard to enter into the rest. Are you living in the rest, in the peace of God today? Are you allowing yourself plenty of time to fix your eyes on Jesus, keep your eyes on him? And let him overcome the anxiety, let him overcome the uncertainty, let him overcome the worry, let him overcome the chaos, let him overcome anything that is an enemy to your peace. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace. Sit here with me. Enjoy the peace of God. Nothing but the sounds of nature. It's a beautiful silence. Where can you go today to be still and know that he's God? I love y'all. See you soon.